concept of so-called jury nullification or conscientious acquittal is absolutely central to the common law conception of the jury. And the jury in England was understood to be a body that was designed to stand between citizens and the potentially tyrannical government. So we had cases where it was very clear that the king was simply trying to get payback against a political opponent or to punish somebody who had challenged the king in some way. And the advent of a jury, of a body of citizens who could prevent the king from doing that, was one of the most important developments of the common law. There's a question about whether there were competing views about the role of jury nullification or conscientious acquittal during the founding era. And I would say yes, but we shouldn't overdo it. Blackstone was one of the important commentators on common law at the time. He seems to have subscribed to the idea that jurors should simply be fact-finding bodies, but he doesn't seem to have been in a majority. In fact, he seems to have been in a distinct minority. And we know, for example, that John Adams took a much different view of the proper role of juries and felt that they should decide not only facts, but also determine legal questions. And he, in fact, overtly argued that in a number of the cases in which he participated as defense counsel. Perhaps the most celebrated criminal prosecution on American soil at the time of the founding was the prosecution of New York publisher John Peter Zenger for criminal libel, which he was clearly guilty of. He had said some very libelous things about the colonial governor of New York, who took it amiss and initiated a prosecution. Zenger was ultimately acquitted by a jury in the face of the evidence. Again, there was no doubt that he was guilty of the crime of libel for which he had been charged. His lawyer validly argued jury nullification to the jury, said you should acquit not because he's innocent, but you should acquit because to convict would be unjust. He was in fact acquitted, and that trial and that conscientious acquittal by that jury is probably the single most celebrated criminal trial in American history at the time of the founding. The idea that juries can and should make legal determinations is actually written into the very text of a number of state constitutions. It was central to the founding era conception of what a jury was.
So at common law, we had a very different system. At the time, we didn't have elected prosecutors. We couldn't elect the king. The jury was a jury of your peers in the sense of landed gentry white men. We also didn't have appeals. We didn't even have defense attorneys. At common law, you weren't allowed to bring your own lawyer into the courtroom. We had often private prosecution, and the sentence was often death, which was carried out later that day. That was a time in which we had substantially more jury nullification, but it was also a very different world of criminal prosecution, one that I think we probably wouldn't want to go back to. That was a system in which there was a lot of injustice and in which jury nullification played an important safety valve. We have other safety valves today. We have trial procedures. We have defense attorneys. We have democratically elected prosecutors. We have democratically elected legislators. It's a different system today, and one in which there's less of a need for jury nullification than existed at the founding. Probably the most famous example of jury nullification is the acquittal of the murderers of Emmett Till in the Deep South in the 1950s. Emmett Till, a 14-year-old African-American boy who was accused of looking at a white woman and was brutally murdered. His body so badly manipulated, his body was almost identifiable. The people who murdered Emmett Till were prosecuted for that murder. The evidence was overwhelming, and yet the all-white jury acquitted, exercising what sure looks like jury nullification. What that shows us is that jury nullification is a tool that can be used for justice, but it's also a tool that can be equally used for injustice. And the question is how you would ensure the just uses and not the unjust uses. And the problem is we all may disagree about what is just and what is not. And I think that makes jury nullification a tool, which sounds great in theory, but is really quite troubling in practice.